Hey there, Salt Shaker friends! Casey here. Welcome to NXTGEN Live! Today, we're going to have an exciting Bible story. But before that, I want you guys to leave your suggestions, comments, and use hashtag NXTGEN Live, hashtag NXTGEN Salt Shakers. Now, who's ready to listen to the Bible story? Are your eyes, ears, and hearts ready? Are you ready? Count down with me. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hello, kids. How are you? My name is Teacher Leana, and on my phone is Zoey.
Hi, kids. I'm Zoey.
Zoey and I are just getting ready for today's Bible story. In fact, now is a good time to call everybody at home to listen in.
Yeah! And Teacher Leana, let's say hi to all the daddies, mommies, lolos, lolas, ates, and kuyas who are joining us today.
Hi!
Hi!
Zoey may be an elephant, but she's one of my very best friends. Do you have best friends too? What do you like about them? We may like our best friends because they may be nice, loving, and fun to be with. You know, listening to Bible stories every Sunday is one of the things that Zoey and I like to do together.
And since we can't hang out right now, we are staying connected online.
By the way, Zoey, do you remember our memory verse for the month of May?
Yep!
Maybe we can say it together with the families at home.
Great idea!
Let's say it together with the action so it will be more fun. Ready? John chapter 15, verse 12. This is my commandment, that you love one another just as I have loved you. John chapter 15, verse 12. Great job, Zoey! And an awesome job to those of you at home. In this verse, Jesus commands us to love one another, especially those who belong to God's family. But do you know who else we need to love?
How about you, kids? Do you have a clue?
I know! Let's listen to today's Bible story to find out. So if you're ready, let's open up our big blue whale eyes.
And keep those big elephant ears open too as we start the story.
Our story for today comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 43 to 48. One day, Jesus spoke to a crowd of people up on the mountainside.
You have heard that it was said, "Love your neighbor, hate your enemy."
It is common for us to love our neighbors. These are the people who like us and treat us well. Zoey, who do you consider as your neighbor?
Why, you, of course, because you're my best friend.
Aww, you're my neighbor too. Our best friends are easy to love, right? And it is all the more easier to hate our enemies. Our enemies are the people who don't like us. They can say and do hurtful things to us.
Like that mean kid from school?
Or my annoying cousin? Ah! Is there someone whom you think of as your enemy? Is it easy to love your enemy?
No, no, no!
You're right, Zoe. It is tough. Our enemies can seem unlovable, which means it's really difficult to love them. But then, Jesus gave us this hashtag extra challenge.
Ooh, what is this hashtag extra challenge?
Listen, here is what I tell you. Love your enemies. Pray for those who persecute or hurt you. When you do this, you will be children of your Father who is in heaven. He causes his sun to shine on evil people and good people. He sends rain on those who are righteous and those who are unrighteous.
So kids, daddies, mommies, lolos, lolas, ates, kuyas, and everybody else at home, were you able to catch the hashtag extra challenge? What then are we supposed to do with our enemies?
What? We need to love and pray for our enemies? That's the extra challenge?
Oh, that's what Jesus said, Zoey. You see, God loves everyone. He cares even for the people who do wrong. That is why He causes the sun to shine on both the good and the bad people. Now, let's imagine. What do you think will happen to people who don't get sunlight?
Well, they'll get weak or they'll freeze.
Ooh, you're right, Zoe. God doesn't punish people immediately by taking away their sunlight. Instead, God is so loving that He gives them many chances to obey Him and experience His love. But why do you think that Jesus is asking us to love our enemies?
I bet Jesus has the answer. Let's listen to Him.
If you love those who love you, what reward will you get? Even the tax collectors do that.
Tax collectors? Who are they?
Tax collectors are the people in charge of collecting the money that people need to pay the government. During Jesus' time, many tax collectors were not honest. They would often try to cheat by collecting more money so that they can keep it for themselves.
I don't want to be like them. I don't want to be known as a bad elephant.
No one does. No one likes to be called a bad person. But if I only love the people who love me, or only those who are lovable, then I'm just like those tax collectors.
So does this really mean that I should love the people who hate me? The unlovable people? Jesus, should I really love my enemies?
Yes, and if you greet only your neighbor, like only those you know, what more are you doing than others? Even people who are ungodly, like those who do not love God, do that.
Jesus says that if we only love the people who love us back, then we're no different than anyone else in this world. And because we know God, we should do more than those who do not know Him. This means that we should love others more, even those who are unlovable.
You got it right. So be perfect, just as your Father in heaven is perfect.
You mean never, ever making a mistake?
No, Zoey. We will make many mistakes, but we need to ask forgiveness from God. And perfect here means we are made whole by Jesus.
I would really like to follow Jesus, but loving my enemies is so hard. Oh, I don't think I can do the hashtag extra challenge.
Oh, Zoey. Following Jesus isn't always easy. It's really tough to love and even forgive the people who are mean to us. A lot of times, I myself don't love the people who are mean to me. I don't even want to be nice to them. That is why this is an hashtag extra challenge.
Make that an extra, extra, extra challenge.
Actually, we can't do this challenge on our own. But don't worry, because God promises to help us if we ask Him.
Really? God will help us love our enemies?
Definitely.
Then I think I'm ready to take up the hashtag extra challenge now, because God will surely help me. How about all you kids and grown-ups out there? Are you also up for the hashtag extra challenge? Awesome!
Now, let's think. Is there someone you do not like at home or in school? Will you ask the Lord to help you to start loving this person? Good! Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, help us to love perfectly, just like how you love us. Teach us to love our enemies. Help us to do good to those who hate us. Help us to love like you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen!
Here are the discussion questions for today's Bible story. First, is it really possible to love our enemies? How can you say so? Second, in what ways can you show love to people who are mean to you? And third, can you think of someone who is difficult for you to love? Can you commit to pray and ask God to help you love that person?
Zoey and I learned a lot from today's Bible story, and we hope that you did too.
We also hope that your family can continue on talking about the story using the discussion questions.
And don't forget to share this and other Bible stories with your friends so they can also learn about the Word of God. For now, Zoey and I need to go. We are going to talk about the discussion questions. But see you again next Sunday for another Bible story.
Bye! Bye.